Welcome. In this video, we'll see the important pins of 8051. So first we'll start with the IO port pins. So as we know that 8051 is having four IO ports, and these IO ports are used for interfacing external peripherals. So the port names are like P0, P1, P2 and P3. Each of the port is of 8 bits. So the first port is port 0, which is having pins from 32 to 39 on the actual IC, 8051 IC. And the names for that pins are like P0.0 to P0.7. It is again a 8-bit port, which is readable as well as writable. And it is a general purpose IO port. So we can interface external peripherals to this port. Then also it is having additional function, as it can be used as a lower order address and data bus. So the functions are multiplexed, means at a time we can either use this port as a IO port, or we can use this port for interfacing external RAM or external ROM. Then the next one is port 1, which is having pins from 1 to 8 on the actual IC, and the name for port 1 is P1.0 to P1.7. So this is also 8-bit port, which is again a general purpose IO port, and it is a dedicated port. It is not having any other function, so it is just a plain IO port. Next port is port 2, which is having pins from 21 to 28 on the actual IC, and the naming starts from P2.0 to P2.7. Again, this is a 8-bit read write general purpose IO port, which can be used for interfacing external peripherals. And this port is having additional function. So that function is the higher order address bus. So the pins, address pins from A8 to A15, these pins are used for interfacing external memory to 8051. So this port has two functions. One function is that it can be used as an IO port, and the second function is that it can be used as address bus, that is higher order address bus. And the third port, the last port, is port 3, which is having pins from 10 to 17 on the actual IC, and it is having names from P3.0 to P3.7. So this is also a general purpose IO port, 8-bit IO port, which can be used for interfacing external peripherals. Again, along with peripherals, it is having additional functions. So every pin is having a different function. So some of the functions are, it can be used as a input for the external interrupts. So some of the pins are used for giving the clock signal to the timers whenever we are going to operate timer in a counter mode. And some of the pins are related to read-write access of the external memory. So these are the alternate functions that are available for port 3. So as we can see that P3.0 is the read RxD pin, which is used for serial receiving data. So whenever external device is going to send serial data, that serial data will be received by this P3.0 pin, or it is also called as RxD pin. Next is P3.1, which is a transmit pin. So whenever we want to send data from CPU to external peripheral, at that time it can be sent or transmitted serially on P3.1 pin, or it is also called as TXD pin. Then the next two pins, P3.2 and P3.3, are the external interrupt pins, that is external interrupt 0 and external interrupt 1. So whenever any external device wants to interrupt CPU, that signal can be given either to P3.2 or P3.3 pin, so which acts as the interrupt pins. Next two pins, that is P3.4 and P3.5, act as the timer input pins. So whenever we are going to operate timer in counter mode, at that time we have to give external clock signal as an input to the timer. So that clock signal can be applied either to T0 or T1 pins of timer. So T0 is for timer 0 and T1 is for timer 1. And finally, the last two pins, that is P3.6 and P3.7, are the read bar and write bar pins. So whenever we are going to interface external memory to 8051, at that time this read bar pin and write bar pin are used to read and write on the external memory. Then after this we'll see some of the pins which are available on 8051. Among that, one is the external access pin. So this is a active low pin which is used to give access to the external ROM memory. So whenever this pin is low, it means that the program counter is going to fetch the instructions stored in the external memory or external ROM which is interfaced to 8051. So this ALE and PSEN bar pin are used for external ROM. So that slash indicates that it is an active low pin. So whenever we are going to access the program from internal ROM, at that time this EA bar pin should be connected to VCC. Next pin is PSEN bar pin. So this pin is called as program strobe enable. So this is an output pin and it is connected to the output enable of the ROM. So whenever we want to read anything from external ROM, at that time this pin is made low. So whenever this pin is made low, the output enable of ROM is also made low, and the data that is to be read from the ROM location is available on the data bus, and that is read by the CPU. Next is ALE pin. So ALE stands for address latch enable. So it is an output pin and it is an active high pin. So whenever we want to demultiplex the address and data, at that time this ALE signal is generated. So initially data or the value that is available on AD0 to AD7 pins is the address. So to store that address in a latch, external latch, this ALE signal is given. So whenever this ALE signal is given, at that time the address gets stored in the latch, and now we can use this AD0 to AD7 pins as a data pins. So this ALE pin is used to separate out or demultiplex the address and data. Then the next pins are RxD and TxD. So these are the receive and transmit pins of 8051, which are used for serial communication. And these pins are part of port 3. The next pin is RST pin. So this RST pin is reset pin. It is an active high pin. So whenever we want to reset the CPU, at that time we have to give a high signal to this pin. So whenever a high signal is given to this pin, the microcontroller gets resetted, and whatever value is stored in all the registers, that value gets erased. So these are some values present in some registers when a reset signal is given to the CPU. So as you can see, the first register is PC, that is a program counter. So it has the value 0000 hex whenever a reset signal is given. Then the next register is accumulator. It is also having value 00. Next is B register. It is having value 0. Then next is PSW, that is program status word. It is also having value 00. Then we have stack pointer, which is having value 07. So except stack pointer, all the registers are having values 0. So whenever we reset the CPU, at that time stack pointer is initialized to value 07 hex. And one more thing to remember is that all RAM locations are also made 0 whenever a reset signal is given to the CPU. So some other pins of 8051 are VCC. So VCC provides supply voltage to the pin, and a 5 volt supply is required for 8051. Then we also have a ground pin, and two more pins are there, that is XTAL1 and XTAL2. So using these two pins, we can connect a external crystal to the IC, which generates the clock signal. So internal block is there called as crystal oscillator, which generates a clock from this crystal crystal oscillator. So this is about the pins. So in the next lecture we'll see the memory organization of 8051. Thank you.